أعلم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Dear sweet brothers, dear sisters, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our salah. Ameen ya arhamar rahimin. Alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. We just finished salat al-fajr in jama'ah in our masjid here. Alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. May Allah accept it from all of us and help all of us and all Muslim ummah to stand for salat al-fajr. Ameen ya rabbil alameen. Too many of people nowadays, they are suffering and they cannot sleep at night. Some of them, even they go to doctors and they give them pills to sleep. They cannot sleep. They cannot sleep. And this is big ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, favor that He allowed you to sleep at night. Wallahi, yes, go ask those who cannot sleep at night and they're gonna tell you about it, how they are suffering. Suffering. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, His sunnah, sunan kawniyya. He said, وَجَعَلْنَا اللَّيْلَ لِبَاسًا وَجَعَلْنَا النَّهَارَ مَعَاشًا. سُنَنْ بِسُنَنْ الْكَوْنِيَ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى, that He makes us all, even animals, to sleep. Subhanallah. If you cannot sleep, your body will not function. It will not work. Your brain, your mind cannot function in the right way. فسبحانallah, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, He never hide anything from us. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There is no privacy in His life, alayhi salatu wa sallam. أحد الصحابة قال, حتى كان صلى الله عليه وسلم يعلمنا كل شيء حتى الخراءة. سوري يعني. Even when you go to the bathroom, what to do? صلى الله عليه وسلم, he even teach us that. صلى الله عليه وسلم. Yeah. There is some adab for النوم. The etiquette or adab of before you go to your bed. You have to prepare yourself for that time. So, yes. First of all, to sleep in not just a normal sleep, in a good way, to sleep very deep sleep with peace. There is no nightmares or there is no problems at night. And so now shayateen, even those who are sleeping, they are sleeping, subhanAllah, in a different way. A lot of shayateen playing in their mind all night. Ya subhanAllah. Ya. For Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's giving us the way, the sunnah, the etiquette, how to sleep, how to go to your bed. First of all, to be ready, subhanAllah, for that, go make wudu. Go make wudu. Is that fard, ya sheikh? It's not fard. If you make it, it's good for you. If not, okay, there is no sin. Go make wudu. Sunnah Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when you go to your bed, tanfud al-firash, or you can just make like this to the bed or whatever, your blanket, whatever, or with your clothes, bismillah, bismillah, bismillah. Say three times. Bismillah, bismillah, bismillah. And also, from sunnah, to read Surah Al-Kafirun. Bara'a min al-shirk. You're telling Allah, I am not a mushrik, before you sleep. قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا الْكَافِرُونَ لَا أَعْبُدُ مَا تَعْبُدُونَ وَلَا أَنْتُمْ عَابِدُونَ مَا أَعْبُدُ وَلَا أَنَا عَابِدٌ مَا عَبَدْتُمْ وَلَا أَنْتُمْ عَابِدُونَ مَا لَكُمْ دِينُكُمْ وَلِيَ دِينِ. I am free from الشرك يا رب. And sleep. If you die, you go to Jannah. خلاص السنة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. From السنة also to read last two ayah of سورة البقرة. آمن الرسول or لله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض. If you read this ayat or ayat الكرسي also, there is Allah سبحانه وتعالى will appoint a guard, an angel to stand beside you all the night to guard you. There is كفتاه من قرأهما في ليلة كفتاه, you will be satisfied. From the jinn, you will be protected. You're gonna sleep in a good way. Subhanallah. Yes, because remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يعني people nowadays when they wake up with haram and they sleep with haram. Haram, yes, والله العظيم. They do haram when they sleep and they do haram when they wake. You see somebody when he wake up, first thing he's going is even standing in the middle of the night. Maybe he's smoking hashisha or a hookah. He's taking some hookahs, full of hashish or marijuana before he sleep. Wallahi, even subhanallah, even when he wake up, he never say bismillah and يعني, wash his face even when he wake up. He say bismillah rahman rahim. Subhanallah. To read hawakhir, last two ayah of Surah Al-Baqarah, you're gonna be satisfied. Khalas, that's it. Guard, Allah will guard you. And or ayat al-kursi too. No shaitan will come to your house. If you read ayat al-kursi. And also from sunnah, to read قل هو الله أحد and المعوذتين معوذتان before you sleep. قل هو الله أحد معوذتان means قل أعوذ رب الفلق and قل أعوذ رب الناس. In your hand قل هو الله أحد like this. قل هو الله أحد finish it. قل أعوذ رب الفلق finish it. قل أعوذ رب الناس finish it. Or individually is better. قل هو الله أحد 3 times. وتنفث and to wipe your body with your hand. قل هو الله أحد. رسول الله used to do that every night. قل أعوذ برب الفلق 3 times. Read it in your hand. And wipe your body. قل أعوذ برب الناس 3 times. And wipe your body. سبحان الله. It's protection. It's protection. خلاص. No jinn can see you. Nobody can harm you. This is also one thing. One time, I'm telling you the way how to sleep. One time, Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib and Fatima, the daughter of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they heard that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he gets some spoils of the war or the booty of the war. They asked for khadim, servant. You know, Sayyidina Ali was very poor financially. I'm not poor. We are poor, he's not. Yeah, financially, money-wise. He was a worker, Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib. And Sayyidina Fatima, she used to help him working, Hassan, Hussein, and the, subhanAllah, in the house and working hard. And she used to get the water from far away distance. If you look at her hand, the daughter of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it's very, يعني, subhanAllah, it's not soft like our hands now. My hand may be softer than her hand. SubhanAllah, she used to work hard. SubhanAllah, tathanwa, carrying a lot of stuff. They asked, Ya Rasulullah, we need khadim. They went there, he was not there. They found Aisha radiallahu anha. أم المؤمنين and she asked him, where is Rasulullah? He is not here. Fatima and Ali. Please, would you, when he come, to ask him to give us khadim, somebody, you know, servant to help us. And Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he knew. And they said, فأخذنا مجعنا. And we went to bed, to sleep. And Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, at the end of the day, he's tired, but he did not neglect them. He went to their house. And he put himself between Ali and Fatima in the bed. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Said, guys, practically he was teaching them what to do before they sleep. Imagine that, Sayyidina Ali was in a Fatima and he put himself in the, under the blanket between them. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What they were so lucky, Allah. Subhanallah. And the Rasulullah sallam, he said, let me tell you something. Better than the servants, before you sleep overnight, say, Subhanallah 33 times. Alhamdulillah 33 times. Allahu Akbar 34 times. 34 times. And Sayyidina Ali said, even when I was fighting in the battles, I never forget to say this before I sleep. He never forget about it. Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib. See, this is adab. Adab. All of this adab. And there are too many, plenty of du'as. Rasulullah ﷺ, he taught us before you go to your bed too. Easy way, in your sleep in your right side. I see too many special women and the girls that are sleeping in their stomach. This is the way of shaitan when he sleep. And this is jils, and this is people of the hellfire. When they will be punished, they will be on their stomach all the time like this. And this is not good. Because when you sleep, your stomach means you are squeezing your heart. The heart is not comfortable, and the blood will not run in the right way. And you're going to see that not enough oxygen will go to your brain and your blood. And you're going to see too many people snoring. Why? Especially if they have bellies. They're gonna sleep on their bellies. On their belly. What happened? They're going to snore all night. Yeah, all California will listen. Yes, but that's why this is not from Sunnah. This is a gilsat al-shaytan. Nawmat ahl al-nar, the people of hellfire. Subhanallah, when you sleep on your stomach. What about in my left side? Also the same. When you sleep like this side, also your heart is squeezing your heart, putting pressure in your heart. This is not right. What about in your back? In your back, they said this is the nawmat al-mutafakkirin. Who's mutafakkirin nowadays? Allah musta'an. Those who are the thinkers, they always lay in their back like this to think. But who's thinking nowadays? Khallah ala Allah. Thinking about about tabikha. Thinking that. Even the doctors, they said to lay in your back, this is putting pressure in your backbone. This is your عمود الفقري يعني. It's better to sleep in the way of Rasulullah, the way he taught us, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How? In your right side and put your hand here under your right cheek like this. Huh? Put the pressure here. And try to sleep toward the Qibla. The Qibla is here, right? Means your head must be here. And you're right, يعني imagine somebody sleeping here, and this is your right side, and toward the Qibla like this. You must make, it's better to make your bed like that. Your face toward the Qibla where we are praying. You're right, right? Yeah, not your foot toward the Qibla. This is not adab. Fix your face in your room, toward the, your face can be toward the Qibla like that. In the grave, you're gonna sleep like that. Huh? They're gonna put you in the grave the same. Sleep every night like this. Try, try. This is barakah. And why? There is a big Egyptian scholar, I think he's a physician or something. He was talking about the tawaf around the Kaaba and when we sleep and when we make sujood while we are toward the Qibla. Subhanallah, especially when we sleep. بقول لك يعني نظرية الطرد المركزي or the earth is, you know, the movement of the earth and all of that stuff. Subhanallah, all the pressure this عامل لك يعني بقول لك هتبقى يعني زي ما يكون ارضي. All the pressure of your body will go to the earth, especially if you sleep toward the Qibla. I read big research about that. It's not my point. المهم, the point here is
عالم قربان. عالم قربان. عالم قربان.
Who said that?
If that was his explanation, so that's قربان.
No. Don't you have to read first this. I did not explain the details. You cannot judge him. First of all, we cannot belittle people. Second, you have to read before you judge. You have to read everything he said. Then you can put your decision. Doctor, I did not say the whole complete picture about what he said. Just I'm giving you example. You know, and my point now just talk about adab in nom, how Rasulullah used to sleep and how he taught us. But I'm telling you, there are too many researches. The scholars, they talk about it, the benefits of sleeping toward the Qibla. This is my shahid min kalami. But see, go to the internet and read about it. He's gonna give more details. He's gonna convince you. Yeah, he's a scholar. The point here is, read Adab al-Nawm. You can say, Bismika Rabbi, Wada'atu Jambi, Wa Bismika Arfa'u. Too many people, they sleep by the name of somebody else. Now say, Bismika Rabbi, by the name of my Lord, oh my Lord, I put my side and they sleep and you allow me to stand again, to give me life again, subhanAllah. That's why when you wake up in the morning, there are too many du'as also, one of the best of these du'as, الحمد لله الذي أحيانا بعد ما أمتنا وإليه النشور. You praise Allah, the one who gave you life after your death. And النشور, the day of resurrection, belong to him. Oh, he's gonna resurrect us. People are gonna stand from their graves in the day of judgment. These are some of the adab of the etiquette of the sleep, to sleep in a good way. Subhanallah. And this is, I think, this is good prescription for those who cannot sleep at night. What about if you make also wudu and you pray to rak'ah before you sleep? Ya salam, this is the best. This is the best, see? And go to your bed and deep breathe. Make some kind of meditation, kida. And while you're reading the Quran, deep breathe. Hold. Slowly. Like make it like 7 times, 11 times, like this. People, they cannot sleep. Their mind is working 24/7. So that's why, alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, we have the Islam. Rasulullah is giving us the way how to sleep and with comfort and mashallah to spend a very good night, inshallah. And try to avoid the shayateen. Maybe some shayateen also from the human being, they will be around you. They cannot let you sleep. That's better to, you know what I mean? Allah khala nidai. Allahumma khfir lana warhamna. Wasturna wajburna ya Rabbil Alameen. عافينا في أسماعنا وأبصارنا وأبدالنا بأحيتنا يا أرحم الراحمين. تقبل منا واهدنا واسترنا واجبرنا يا أرحم الراحمين. وفقنا لما تحب وترضاه وثبتنا وثقل موازيننا واغفر ذنوبنا. كفر عنا سيئتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار. واغفر زلاتنا يا أرحم الراحمين. وتب علينا يا رب العالمين. ولا توفنا إلا وأنت راض عنا يا أرحم الراحمين. وفقنا لما تحب وترضاه. صلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. جزاكم الله خيرا.